Siren Audio Studios proudly presents Dix Tableaux, based on the stage play Dix Tableaux, written and adapted for audio cinema by Mark Dunn, featuring the performances of Jean Efron as Addie Spool, Ninette Mordaunt as Beverly Duggins, Michelle Smith as Maureen, and Bill Royal as the voice of the program. The story takes place largely in the city of Dix in the American South and spans the first decade of the 21st century. The Museum of Dix wishes to welcome you to its 97th annual Cavalcade of History. We've assembled another delightful assortment of human tableaus for your viewing pleasure this year, each depicting a scene from the history of our fine town. Little House on the Prairie? Well, you wouldn't be far off. These two frontier women demonstrate how the good old days maybe weren't always so good for the industrious lady of the house. Churning butter, beating rugs, what a hard-working pair. There's truth for sure to that old adage, a woman's work is never done. Nice bonnets and aprons, ladies.
Damn. Is the coast clear? Is anybody coming?
Not that I can tell. But then again, I can't really turn my head to look around, so I'd just be guessing.
Hello? Yes, I made it. Everything's fine. I told you, I don't mind. Really, dear, I do not mind. I'm having fun. It's fun. It really is. So when do I get to go home? Oh, no. I'm just curious. There's no need to worry. Stop worrying about me. Bye, dear.
You're not supposed to take phone calls.
What's that?
You're not supposed to take phone calls in the middle of doing the tableau.
Oh, that was my son.
People didn't have cell phones in 1876.
He was checking up on me.
They may have had cups with string.
Can we switch places?
You mean right now?
Yes.
You're tired of beating the rug? You'd rather churn the butter?
My arm is starting to ache a little. It tends to do that when I hold it over my head for long periods of time.
We're allowed to rest between promenaders.
We are?
Yes.
Oh, thank God.
But we have to be vigilant.
What do you mean?
In case anybody comes.
So, should we take turns being on the lookout?
Oh, that sounds like a good plan. I'll go first.
Things were so rushed earlier. I've already forgotten your...
Addie Spool, like a spool of thread.
We really didn't get a proper introduction, did we, Addie?
Well, you missed the orientation. There was coffee and turnovers.
I was a last-minute replacement.
You're Beverly.
Yes, Beverly.
You're Brian's mother.
That's right. That was Brian on the phone.
He's doing very well.
You think so, really? Oh, this being his first year, he wants very badly for everything to go well. He says nobody does these tableaus anymore. It's not an easy sort of thing to pull off.
Well, I guess you can say we're kind of locked into a tradition here. It's part of the town heritage.
Well, yes, that's what I understand.
It used to be very popular, you know.
How long have you been?
Pose!
Don't touch the butter churn, Billy. I'm sorry, Frontier Lady. It's his first tableau. Billy, this isn't the Children's Science Museum.
That isn't a Frontier Lady. That's Miss Fool from the drugstore. Hello, Miss Fool. Hello.
Don't pester the pharmacy lady, Billy. She's trying to be a statue.
I don't know the other woman. I don't know. You're good, though. You're very good. Look, Roger. Look how still she is. She looks almost lifelike.
Yeah.
Don't run, Billy. This is a museum. I guess he got tired of the frontier ladies. Bye, Addie. Goodbye, woman I don't know.
So, Beverly, you were asking how long...
Incoming!
In addition to hard field labor at the side of her husband, a frontier wife was expected to spend her remaining hours cooking and cleaning and tending the youngins. The drudgery was seldom relieved in this era of few household conveniences. Today, these women would engage a babysitter and a housekeeper, then be off to a fitting or an afternoon with the girls? Who wrote this stuff? Hello, Addie. I know you can hear me.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, Use the link in the video description.